Here's some examples of calculations involving arc length. The basic formula that we ran across is that the arc length is always equal to the radius times the angle. And the angle, remember, has to be in radians. Okay, so let's take a look at this example here. I have the angle, 1.5 radians, and the radius of 2 inches. Question is, what's the arc length up there? Well, the arc length should be the radius 2 times the angle, which is 1.5. And that turns out to be 2 times 1.5 would be 3. And that should be in inches. I know the radius, I know the angle, I can put them in. The angle is already in radians, so we're all set. Okay. Here's another one. This time I tell you the arc length and the angle. It's still that the arc length is the radius times the angle, but this time I don't know the radius. So I can solve for the radius by dividing by the angle here. That the arc length divided by the angle should equal the radius. So here we go. The radius is equal to the arc length of 15 divided by the angle of 2.6 radians. So 15 divided by 2.6, whatever that is. Quickly check my calculator, and it tells me it's 5.7 something, 5.769, goofy number here, 2, 3, whatever. If you know two of these, you can find the third one. So I've got the angle and the arc, I can find the radius. Right? And let's see, just to be careful here, the radius, that was measured in centimeters, so this is also in centimeters, all right, that radius there. Next, I have the radius and the arc, but I'm looking for the angle. It's still the case that the arc length is the radius times the angle. So if I want the angle, I'm going to divide by r. S divided by r. And there goes my squeaky pen again. So plug this in. This would be theta equals the arc length of 9 feet divided by the radius of 4 feet, which gives 9/4, which is 2.25. Is that right? 2.25. So clearly I didn't draw this to scale, because an angle of 2.25 would be more in that range. Right. Okay. This is an interesting one right here, because look at what happens. When you take arc length and divide it by radius, you have the same label top and bottom. Essentially, the labels just cancel out, and the answer here is 2.25. It's not 2.25 degrees or 2.25 miles or inches, or, you know, typically when you're dividing numbers with units attached, like when you're calculating speed, for instance, you traveled 50 miles in 3 hours, right? So here's a little aside. If you travel 50 miles, and let's pick a better number, 2 hours, right? 50 divided by 2 is 25, but miles divided by hours is miles per hour, right? This is 50 miles in 2 hours is an average of 25 miles per hour. The labels tell you what the units of the result are. And yet here, feet divided by feet is nothing. There is no unit. And this is one of the reasons why radian measure is sometimes called the natural angle measure. It has no unit. You don't have to say 2.25 radians. You could just say, hey, I got an angle of 2.25. The only angle measurement that makes sense to not have a unit attached to it is radian measure. So if you say an angle of 2.25, I know you mean 2.25 radians, right? One of the reasons I'm very careful when people say, hey, I got an angle of 30. It's like, 30 degrees? Yeah. Speaking of 30 degrees, here's a situation. I've got a 30-degree angle, I got a 5 meter radius. I want to know what's the arc length. Right? Well, the arc length is the angle times the radian. The angle times the radius. So theta times the radius. I can't tell you how many times I've given a problem like this on a quiz or a test, and I have students do this. They say the arc length is equal to 30 times 5, which would be 150. And then I come back and I look at them and I say, okay, this is 5 meters, and this is how much? 150 meters? It doesn't even look like it's 5 meters long. I mean, it's shorter than this one. How the heck could that be the right answer? How the heck could this be right? This is not right. This is just, no, please don't do that. Okay, what's wrong with it? Well, the problem is you're doing this problem in radians. This formula doesn't apply unless the angle is in radians. You did it in degrees. Did I say you did it in radians? You didn't do it in radians. You did it in degrees. It should be in radians. So here we go. First thing I have to do on a problem like this is I've got to take that 30 degree angle and say, how do I convert that to radians? Well, what's my exchange rate? My exchange rate is the straight angle, right? I can call that 180 degrees, or I could call that pi radians. It's the same. Oops, pi radians. So the degrees are going to cancel out, and I'm left with, I think this is pi divided by 6, right? The zeros cancel out. There's a pi divided by 6 radians. So if the angle is pi divided by 6, which is a little more than a half, right? Because pi is a little more than 3. So if you divide by 6, it's almost like a 3 over 6, which would be a half. So this is a little more than half a radian. So if I do now this arc length formula, the arc length is the angle, pi over 6 radians, times the radius of 5 meters, gives me an arc length of 5 pi over 6 meters. And as a decimal, let's turn my calculator on here, 5 times pi divided by 6, it looks like 2.61799, whatever. Just as a reality check, 2.6 is definitely smaller than 5. That looks good. That arc length looks smaller. Thinking in terms of the angle here, pi divided by 6 is a little bit bigger than a half, so I would expect an arc length of a little bit bigger than a half of 5. Well, half of 5 would be 2.5, and I'm at 2.6 something, so okay, I'll take that. All right. This relationship, S equals R theta. If you know any of the two, you can get the third one. But be careful, the angle has to be in radians.